Hey everyone, this is Michael again, and welcome to my DVD and Blu-ray update for February 25th. And in this update, got a lot of stuff to show, have a lot to show you all. Some of also the DVD, the Blu-rays that I've gotten for Christmas, which you probably saw on my Christmas morning vlog if you've seen it. So yeah, so let's get started with the DVD Blu-ray update. And the first two I'm going to show, I have 3 and 4 on Blu-ray, but I never had 1 and 2. Sorry about that, but I was saying I have 3 and 4 on Blu-ray, but I never owned the first two, so I got these from Amazon. They were pretty cheap, and that is Transformers. This is the first film. On Blu-ray, this is the 2-disc special edition. Of course, it stars Shia LaBeouf, Tyrese Gibson, Josh Duhamel, Anthony Anderson, Megan Fox, John Turturro, John Voight. Did a review of all the Transformer films from the first one to the fourth one. Can't wait until The Last Knight comes out this year. Transformers: The Last Knight, which I'm gonna give a look. So yeah. Back to it. Disc one has a commentary by director Michael Bay. Transformers heads-up display. View Transformers like never before. Picture-in-picture, behind-the-scenes information, and more. BD Live features. Disc two. All the features on disc two are in HD. Has Our World. Explored the world of Transformers through interviews with the cast and crew, stunt training footage, and exclusive access to the on-set locations. Their War, learn more about the Autobots and Decepticons with exclusive access to production design, military advisors, and digital special effects, and More Than Meets the Eye. Experience an in-depth featurette on the making of the Scorponok Desert attack scene, concept boards, and theatrical trailers. So that's Transformers. The first film on Blu-ray. And then also picked up Transformers Revenge of the Fallen, which, yes, I do enjoy this film. No, a lot of people don't like it. No, a lot of people say it's the worst Transformers film. But it does have a lot of problems, though, because from the script, because the script was written during the writer's strike. Although I enjoyed the film, it's a fun film. It's not perfect or great. Well, neither of the Transformer films are great or perfect, though. But has a lot of features. This is the big screen, the 2-disc big screen edition, which was only available at Walmart. When you watch the film, has some of the IMAX. You can see like the IMAX. Scenes that they shot with the film. So, but it has features on disc one. It has commentary by director Michael Bay and writers Roberto Orci, I think that's how you pronounce his last name, and Alex Kurtzman. Disc two has the human factor exact in Revenge of the Fallen, deconstructing visual Bayham, Nest Transformer data hub, much more. Blu-ray exclusive includes the AllSpark experiment. So yeah, so it did come with its original slipcover. There's what the Blu-ray looks like. It has Bumblebee there. There's the back to it. So yeah, so that's Transformers: Revenge of the Fallen. Had to peel the sticker off right there because it was covering the name of the film. So. As Transformers Revenge of the Fallen. So now I have all the Transformer films on Blu-ray, 1 to 4. So picked up those. Sorry about that, but then I also picked up Batman v Superman, Dawn of Justice. This is the Ultimate Edition, which includes the theatrical and the director's cut, the Ultimate Edition, which has 30 more minutes not seen in theaters, which I still have yet to check out, though. But I heard It's a lot better than the theatrical version. But I enjoy BVS. I saw it in theaters. Really liked it. I know it has a lot of problems. A lot of people don't like it. It's problems from like the editing to Jesse Eisenberg's Lex Luthor. I enjoyed seeing Ben Affleck and Henry Cavill go at it as Batman and Superman. I enjoyed seeing them on screen. You have Gal Gadot as Wonder Woman in the film too. So, but it includes 2 hours of special features: Uniting the World's Finest, Gods and Men, A Meeting of Giants, The Warrior, The Myth, The Wonder, Accelerating Design, New Batmobile, and a whole lot more. But yeah, I did a review of Batman v Superman. If you haven't seen my review of it, check it out. But yes, that's Batman v Superman: Dawn of Justice. Really enjoyed the film, even though, like I said, it has a lot of problems though. And then I picked these up after I think it was on Cyber Monday, because they were very cheap. This one I got for $9 during that during that Cyber Monday. I've been wanting to check out the film, which I did, gave it a watch, and it's Nerve with Emma Roberts and Dave Franco, and it's an awesome movie. Really enjoyed it. It's put it on my list of favorite films of last year. If you saw that video, this film was on my list. But it's a very enjoyable, intense film that I really enjoyed. I want to do a review of this film, but it has features on it. It has Are You a Watcher or a Player type features on the back right there. For the watcher mode, it has create a Nerve, 15 character pods, The Fat Jewish Gets Tate Wish Outtakes, The Governor's Ball Takeover, Social Media Stars in the Game of Dare. And for the player mode features, it has Do You Have the Nerve game, an interactive game of Dare, Are You a Watcher or a Player quiz, and player profiles. So that's Nerve. Awesome movie. If you haven't seen it, check it out. And then this one I also got cheap and been wanting to get this one. And it's Who Framed Roger Rabbit, the 25th Anniversary Edition. It's a two-disc Blu-ray. Well, no, it's a two-disc combo. Has disc one is the Blu-ray and disc two is the DVD. But what more can I say about Who Framed Roger Rabbit? It's a classic film, very over the top, hilarious movie. Animation is amazing. Of course, stars Bob Hoskins, the late great Bob Hoskins, Christopher Lloyd, Charles Fleischer, who voices Roger Rabbit, and Joanna Cassidy. Of course, directed by Robert Zemeckis. But the Blu-ray has a lot of features. It has the Roger Rabbit shorts, digitally restored, which looks great. Who Made Roger Rabbit? A mini documentary hosted by Charles Fleischer, the voice of Roger Rabbit, which you can find here on YouTube. Has a commentary with filmmakers Robert Zemeckis, Frank Marshall, Jeffrey Price, Peter Seaman, Stephen Starkey, and Ken Ralston. Toontown Confidential viewing option with intriguing and hilarious facts and trivia. Deleted scene, the pig head sequence with filmmaker commentary, which I think that's also here on YouTube, the pig head scene. Before and after split screen comparison with and without animation. Behind the Ears, the true story of Roger Rabbit. It's an exclusive in-depth behind the scenes documentary. Tune stand-ins featurette, rehearsing with stand-ins for the tunes, and on set, Benny the Cab, the making of a scene from the film. And disc two on the DVD has the Valiant files, which is an interactive set-top gallery, and a whole lot more. But the picture quality on this was okay, but it could have been a lot better, in my opinion. But Yes, yeah, so Who Framed Roger Rabbit 25th Anniversary Edition. If you don't have this edition, definitely pick it up. I was surprised it actually came with its original slipcover, though. So, yes, that's Who Framed Roger Rabbit 25th Anniversary Edition. Then I got this at Best Buy. It was very cheap. It was like $9, I think it was. But I got this with my Best Buy gift card. That I received. That is the Independence Day 20th Anniversary Edition, which includes the theatrical and extended cut. Also has the movie. They gave it a new 4K restoration of the film. Haven't been able to check it out yet, the new restoration of the film. But has on disc one, a combat review, ID4 data stream trivia track on the theatrical version, commentary by Roland Emmerich and Dean Devlin on bulk cuts, commentary by Oscar Wynn special effects supervisors Volker Engel and Doug Smith. So that's on disc one. Disc two has an all new 30-minute documentary, Independence Day: A Legacy, Surging Forward, Gag Reel, Creating Reality, ID4 Invasion Mockumentary, The Making of ID4, Modern Earth Broadcasting Gallery, and that's pretty much, and that's all the features that are on it. But they did this because of Independence Day Resurgence, which I still need to pick up though. Probably when it's very cheap though, because I liked Independence Day Resurgence as a guilty pleasure. It's not as good as, of course, the original film, but you know. So hopefully pick it up one day. So yes, that's Independence Day, the 20th anniversary edition, which includes the theatrical and extended cuts. So yeah, so if you don't have that on Blu-ray, I think that's the best edition to get, because they have the original Blu-ray that came out. But you know, since it got a 4K restoration, that's the best Independence Day Blu-ray that you have to pick up. You know, sell your original Blu-ray and get that one if you don't have it. So, and then I also picked up Suicide Squad, which stars Will Smith, Jared Leto, Margot Robbie, Joel Kinnaman, and Viola Davis. Really enjoyed the film. It's a fun film. Guilty pleasure. Know a lot of people don't like it, though, but I enjoy it. I think, in my opinion, Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn, she stole the show. Really enjoyed Will Smith as Deathshot. But yeah, awesome film. Saw it in theaters. A lot of people I saw it in theaters with, the people that were in there. They pretty much enjoyed the film. You know, they were laughing at the scenes that, you know, were funny. Jared Leto's Joker, I liked, but could have been a lot more scenes with him in it. I understand that they filmed some more scenes with Jared Leto's Joker, but they didn't include it, and he got pissed off because they didn't include all the scenes that he shot. So. But yeah, it was reshot a couple of times, the film, from what I read. So, but has features on it, has Task Force X, One Team, One Mission, Squad Strength and Skills, Joker and Harley, The It Couple of the Underworld, Chasing the Reel, Gag Reel, and a whole lot more. So, but yeah, I also did a review of Suicide Squad. Check it out if you haven't seen it. So yes, that's Suicide Squad extended cut, which I heard the extended cut doesn't do the film justice. So yeah, I forgot to mention I did a review of Independence Day 2 along with Resurgence when that came out. So if you haven't checked out those reviews of mine, go check it out. And then picked this up off of Amazon. Picked it up for $17. Been waiting for the price for the film to go down. and I finally got it. It's the collector's edition of Child's Play, the original classic Chucky film, which stars Catherine Hicks, Chris Sarandon, Alex Vincent, Brad Dourif, who does the voice of Chucky. I haven't seen the other Chucky films, like Child's Play 2. I mean, Child's Play 2, I saw a couple of scenes, but not the whole film. Child's Play 3, I heard, was shitty. Bride of Chucky, I heard, was mixed. Some people liked it, some people hated it. See a Chucky, I heard, was a pile of shit. And then they did Curse of Chucky, which I heard good things about. And then this year they're doing an, and then this year another Chucky film is coming out, from what I heard. So, we'll eventually watch them all at some point. But this the new this the Scream Factory, Shout Factory Blu-ray has a new 2K scan of the original negative. But all of you know what Child's Play is about, so it's a classic. It's a classic horror film. Two-disc Blu-ray has commentary with director Tom Holland, commentary with actors Alex Vincent and Catherine Hicks and Chucky designer Kevin Yeager, commentary with producer David Kirschner and screenwriter Don Mancini. Chucky commentaries on select scenes, which that was probably on the Chucky's birthday edition, the I think it was the 20th anniversary edition that came out in 2008. Disc 2 has new behind the scenes footage from special effects supervisor Howard Berger, new Howard Berger, your special effects friend till the end, new life behind the mask behind Chucky with Ed Gale. Evil comes in small packages featuring interviews with Don Mancini, David Kirschner, screenwriter John Lafia, actors Chris Sarandon, Brad Dourif, Catherine Hicks, and Alex Vincent, and Kevin Yeager. Chucky building a nightmare, a monster convention, introducing Chucky, the making of Child's Play, vintage featurette, the trailer, and behind the scenes photo gallery. The film looks amazing on Blu-ray, the picture quality, that new 2K, that new 2K scan looks amazing. The audio is great too. Of course, it has a slip cover. What's really cool is if you take it out, a lot of the Shout Factory, Scream Factory Blu-rays include this, but has the new artwork. And then when you take it out, it has the original poster to it, which is cool, which I like. But yeah, so that's Child's Play Collector's Edition on Blu-ray. Very cool, very cool, very good Blu-ray. So, but yeah, and this is how it looks like when you change the when you change the artwork, which is awesome. So that's the collector's edition of Child's Play, and I really want to get more of the Scream Factory Blu-rays, like UHF with Weird Al Yankovic, the Bill and Ted's Most Excellent Collection, which has both films, and also the Thing Collector's Edition, which been waiting for that to go down in price though, but it hasn't though. So yeah, so if you haven't got Child's Play on Blu-ray, this is the best edition to get. So yeah, so pick it up if you don't have it. And the next one that I got for I received for Christmas, and I showed this in my Christmas morning vlog. I received Captain America: Civil War, which stars Chris Evans, Robert Downey Jr., Scarlett Johansson, Sebastian Stan, Anthony Mackie, Don Cheadle, Jeremy Renner, Chadwick Boseman, Paul Bettany, Elizabeth Olsen, and Daniel Brühl. Saw this in theaters last year. Really enjoyed it. It was on my list of favorite films of last year. Did a review on it, so if you haven't seen my review, check it out of it. But I enjoyed a whole lot of scenes in the film. Like the airport scene is the best scene in my opinion, where they're all going at it. Also, when Ant-Man becomes Giant Ant-Man, that was really amazing to see. on the when I saw it on the big screen. But the features it has on it has United We Stand, Divided We Fall, the making of Captain America Civil War. It's a two-part making of Captain America, The Road to Civil War, Iron Man, The Road to Civil War, Open Your Mind, behind the scenes look at Marvel's Doctor Strange, which is coming out to Blu-ray this Tuesday, commentary with Joe and Anthony Russo and screenwriters, gag reel, and deleted and extended scenes. So yeah, so if you haven't seen Captain America Civil War, definitely check it out. It's a very good it's a very good movie. Probably, in my opinion, one of the best Marvel films last year, along with Deadpool. So yeah, so those are all the movies that I had. Now on to the TV shows that I had that I got and received. The first one I picked up, got this at Best Buy. It was cheap. It's Arrow, the complete third season. Stars Stephen Amell. And this season was disappointing, in my opinion. It had a lot of problems, like from where we get introduced to Ra's al Ghul and the League of Assassins, which in that half of the season where they get to the League of Assassins, that's when the season starts to drag a whole lot. They made Felicity into a whiny person in this season. She's always whining, bitching, moaning, which that's not how I want to think of Felicity. You know, Felicity's supposed to be this happy, you know, hacker person. It's very nice. But what I did like in this season was we got to see Laurel become Black Canary. So also this the season where we get introduced to Brandon Routh, Ray Palmer, which he plays, and he also becomes Adam. So yeah, the features it has on here has Second Skins, creating the uniform of the uniforms of Arrow, Nada Parbat, constructing the villain's lair, two key commentaries with executive producers Mark Guggenheim and Wendy Merciel, Arrow at Comic-Con 2014, The Man Behind the Suit, The Adam's First Fight, Gag Reel, and Unaired Scenes. So yes, that's Arrow Season 3 on Blu-ray. Disappointing season. And then I also received, for Christmas, Arrow Season 4, which this season started out good, but eventually it was another disappointing season. Really liked Damian Dark storyline. But that ended up becoming boring as the season went on. Another thing that was disappointing is that they killed off Laurel, Black Canary, in this season. This season set up the spin-off show, Legends of Tomorrow, which I really enjoyed that show too, which I got to pick up the Blu-ray to that, season one. Yeah, features it has four featurettes: Star-Crossed Hawks, Star-Crossed Hawks, The Hunt for Vandal Savage, Smooth Criminal, The Damian Dark Story, and Arrow 2015 Comic-Con Panel, exciting crossover event with The Flash, Unaired Scenes, and Gag Reel. So yes, that's Arrow Season 4. I have to say, the current season of Arrow, Season 5, that's on TV right now, much, much better than these two seasons. Whole lot better. Got introduced to new characters. You know, Oliver, Stephen Amell's character, recruited new people to be on his team, from Rory and Wild Dog, which they did the Wild Dog backstory. Not in this past Wednesday's episode, but the following week, which I enjoyed that. So, but yes, like I said, season 5, this current season of Arrow, whole lot better than 3 and 4. So, and then I also received for Christmas Gotham Season 2. Really love this show. One of my favorite shows on Monday nights. Sadly, it's Fox put on a long break this season, this current season, and won't be back until I think May. So, but yeah, it was for some stupid reason they put it on break to put the 24 Legacy and that show APV. But yeah, but Gotham Season 2, they did a complete 180 for this season. It was a lot better than Season 1, though. More direction. We get introduced to new villains. So, this has 90 minutes of special features. It includes Alfred, Batman's greatest ally, Gotham by Noir Light, Kohard, the Tale of Victor Fries, character profiles, Gotham 2015 Comic-Con panel, and a whole lot more. So, Gotham Season 2, really good season. And then, The Flash Season 2, which I also received for Christmas, which I really enjoyed this season. A lot of people I saw didn't like it for some reason, but I enjoyed it. I really enjoyed the villain of Zoom. Zoom was awesome as a villain. It has 4 hours of special features. It has exciting hour crossover event with two special features. Behind-the-scenes visual effects on select episodes loaded with featurettes, including the many faces of Zoom and Chasing Flash, The Journey of Kevin Smith, The Flash 2015 Comic-Con panel, deleted scenes, and a gag reel. So, yeah, so Flash Season 2, good season. And then, let's see, do this next. Also received for Christmas the complete series of 66 Batman, which is awesome. Awesome looking set, which I gotta review this whole set. I know it's out on Blu-ray in a new big set, but this also is on the what was on the back of the DVD. But I'm fine with the DVD, the DVD version. I have the first season separate on DVD, which probably I'm gonna get rid of or sell. So, but yeah, I like the back to it where it says PAL, which is that's really cool. But features it has on here, it has over 3 hours of all new extras, Holy Memorabilia Batman, a journey into the most sought after collectibles through the eyes of three extraordinary collectors, Hanging with Batman, a true slice of life with Adam West, experience a celebration of his achievement in his own words, Batmania Born, building the world of Batman, explore the art and design behind the fiction, Bats of the Round Table, join in a chat with Adam West and celebrity friends, Inventing Batman in the words of Adam West, has through original script notes, Adam discusses the craft of acting and recounts bringing Batman to life, Na-na-na Batman, Hollywood stars and producers recount favorite Batman memories, and Bat Rarity Straight from the Vault, which is has a whole lot of features. So, and each and all the episodes are remastered in HD. So, but yeah, we'll do a review of this set at some point, because you know, it's an awesome looking set. So yeah, so if you don't have this, highly get it. It's worth the money. It's great. And then, also received for Christmas, Season 6 of The Walking Dead, which was a good season, which I liked. Of course, this the season at the end of, this is the season where we get introduced to Negan, which is cool. Feature, and then we had to wait all those months until October to reveal who Negan killed. Which that sucked though. Which I saw a lot of people complained about. But the features on here has episode 16, Last Day on Earth, the extended version, Making of the Walking Dead, In Memoriam, 601, Out of the Quarry, Guts and Glory, The Death of Nicholas, Strength and Bonds, Negan, Someone to Fear. Yeah, Negan, Someone to Fear, the Face of Death, Iconic Walkers. Commentaries and deleted scenes. It's a 5-disc Blu-ray. So yeah, so Season 6 of The Walking Dead. It was a good season. Season 7, I think is all right, though. Has its ups and downs, though. But, kind of enjoying season 7. And the last one I got was Scream Queens, the complete first season. Stars Emma Roberts, Jamie Lee Curtis, Lea Michele, Billy Lord. Very fun show created by Ryan Murphy, who created Glee and Nip Tuck, which I haven't seen those shows though, but I know he created them. But probably will never watch Glee because that's not my type of show. So, but yeah, so Scream Queens, basically the first season is about takes place at a university. Jamie Lee Curtis is the dean of it, and there's this killer named the Red Devil that's on the loose, and it's basically the Red Devil goes around killing people at the university. You have Emma Roberts, who plays this sort of bitchy character named Chanel Oberlin, and her friends are all named Chanel. Like, you have Chanel number 2, Chanel number 3, number 5. Which that's basically how the show is, basically what the show is about. But it's basically just all them trying to escape from the Red Devil from killing them. But it's a very funny show. Really enjoy it. Really love Emma Roberts' character in the show. But the features it has a Rush Kappa, Between Two Queens, and Style Queens. So here's the back to it. But it's a 4-disc set, which is really cool. There's the poster for season 2. There's a season 2 poster of Scream Queens, where it takes place in a hospital, which I enjoyed the second season, although it wasn't as good as the first season. Like I said, yeah. So here's the disc to it. And then there's the picture of the Red Devil right there. Which they actually sold. I saw online that they actually sold the costume to it on. I think it was on the Fox shop. So, but then you have all the episodes on right there. But yes, Scream Queens. If you haven't seen the show, check it out. It's not a show for everybody, in my opinion, but it's a very funny show. It's turn off your brain, fun show. It's not great or perfect though, but. Definitely check it out. Also, Billy Lord was cool in it as Chanel number 3. Feel really bad about her, losing her mom and her grandmother. Her mother was Carrie Fisher, her grandmother was Debbie Reynolds. But she wears those. Her character wears the earmuffs in the show, and that's an ode to Carrie Fisher, her mom, where she had the curls, for her famous Princess Leia character in Star Wars. So that's why she wears the that's why her character wears the earmuffs in the show, an ode to her mother. So, but that's really cool though. So yeah, so Scream Queens, if you haven't checked out the show, definitely check it out, give it a watch. So yeah, so anyways, that's it for my DVD and Blu-ray update for February 25th. Thank you all for watching, and until the next video, which will probably be my review of Raw this Monday. So until that video, I'll see you all later.